name. We thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your loving kindness. Lord, we glorify your name. This evening we confess that all power belongs to you. All glory belongs to you. All power belongs to you. All glory belongs to you. In Jesus' name. Let us open our Bibles this evening. In the book of Luke, chapter 7. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All fear is gone. We can face tomorrow because he lives. All fear is gone. We can face tomorrow. Bible says in Luke chapter 7 verse
36.
Now one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to have a dinner with him. So he went to the Pharisee's house and reclined at the table, verse 37. When a woman who had lived a sinful life in that town learned that Jesus was eating at the Pharisee's house, she brought an alabaster jar of perfume. Verse 38, and as she stood behind him at his feet weeping, she began to wet his feet with her tears. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and poured perfume on them. Next, verse 39, when the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, if this man were a prophet, he would know who is touching him and what kind of woman she is, that she is a sinner. Verse 40, Jesus answered him, Simon, I have something to tell you. Tell me, teacher, he said. Two men owed money to a certain money lender, one owed him 500 denarii and the other 50. Neither of them had the money to pay him back, so he cancelled the debts of both. Now, which of them will love him more? Simon replied, I suppose the one who had the bigger debt cancelled. You have judged correctly, Jesus said. Then he turned toward the woman and said to Simon, do you see this woman? I have come into your house. You did not give me any water for my feet, but she wet my feet with her tears and wiped them with her hair. Next, you did not give me a kiss, but this woman from the time I entered has not stopped kissing my feet. You did not put oil on my hair, but she has poured perfume on my feet. Therefore I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven, for she loved much. But he who has been forgiven little, loves little. Next verse, then Jesus said to her, your sins are forgiven. Verse 49, the other guests began to say among themselves, who is this who even forgives sins? The last one, verse 15, Jesus said to the woman, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. Let's go back to verse 36. Now one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to have dinner with him. So he went to the Pharisee's house and reclined at the table. Just read that verse alone, verse 36.
Mtu mmoja katika mafarisayo alimwalika ale chakula kwake. Akaingia katika nyumba yake ile mfarisayo akaketi chakulani.
One of the Pharisees asked him to eat with him, and he went into the Pharisee's house and reclined at table.
Mmoja wa mafarisayo akamuuliza aje kwake kwa sababu ya mamkuli na akaingia kwa nyumba ya huyo mfarisayo na akaketi mezani.
This evening I'm speaking about.
Shoni leo ninanena kuhusu.
Benefits of reclining at a table with Jesus Christ.
Faida za kuketi kwenye meza na Yesu Kristo.
Benefits of reclining.
Faida
at a table with Jesus Christ.
Za kuketi kwenye meza na Yesu Kristo.
The Bible has told us from that verse.
Andiko umetuambia katika hiyo mstari.
Verse 36.
Aya yake ya 36.
Now one of the Pharisees invited Jesus to have dinner with him.
Jawapo mafarisayo kumwalika Yesu kuwa na chakula cha jioni naye.
So he went to the Pharisee's house.
Katika nyumba ya huyo mfarisayo.
And reclined at the table.
Na kaketi mezani.
Benefits of reclining at the table with Jesus Christ.
Faida za kuketi kwenye meza. na Yesu Kristo.
And this evening we are about to partake of the Lord's table.
Na jioni ya leo tunakaribia kumega meza ya Bwana.
We are about to share the Holy Communion.
Tunakaribia kushiriki meza takatifu.
We are about to recline at the table of Jesus Christ.
Tunakaribia kusongelea meza na Yesu Kristo.
He told the disciples to be doing this in remembrance of him.
Akawaambia wanafunzi fanyeni hivi kwa kunikumbuka mimi.
In fact, he told them to be doing it oftenly.
Na kuwaambia wafanye kwa karibu.
In many times.
Mara nyingi.
In remembrance of him.
Kwa ajili ya kumkumbuka yeye.
So we are about to partake of the Holy Communion.
Tunakaribia tunamega meza.
We are about to partake of the Lord's table.
Tunakaribia kumega meza ya Bwana.
This evening we are looking at benefits of reclining at the table with Jesus Christ.
Yoni ndio tunamalia faida za kukaa mezani na Yesu Kristo.
When we talk about reclining at the table of Jesus Christ.
Tunena kuhusu kukaa mezani na Yesu.
We are talking about having closer fellowship with him.
Tunaenda kuwa na uhusiano wa karibu naye.
Having a closer fellowship with him.
Kuwa na uhusiano wa karibu na Yesu.
We are talking about knowing Jesus Christ.
Tunaenda kuhusu kumjua Yesu Kristo.
Knowing Jesus Christ.
Tunaenda kuhusu kumjua Yesu Kristo.
On Sunday our spiritual father was teaching us.
Mapili baba yetu alikuwa anatufunza.
That Paul said.
Paul akasema.
That I may know.
Ya kwamba niweze kumjua.
The power.
Vile nguvu
of his resurrection.
Za kufufuka kwake.
The power.
Nguvu.
And I know him.
Ili nimjue yeye.
And the power of his resurrection.
Na nguvu zake za kufufuka kwake.
And share in his sufferings.
Na niweze kushiriki katika mateso yake.
We talk about the reclining at the table with Jesus Christ.
Na kusema kuhusu kuketi mezani na Yesu.
We are talking about knowing him.
Tunaongea kuhusu kumjua.
Many people know about Jesus Christ.
Wengi wafahamu kuhusu Yesu Kristo.
But they do not know Jesus Christ.
Lakini hawamjui Yesu Kristo.
God says that I may know him.
Paulo anasema ili nimjue.
God does not say that I may know about him.
Paulo anasema ya kwamba ili niweze kujua kumhusu.
He wants to know him.
Yeye anataka kumjua.
So we are talking about knowing Jesus Christ.
Tunaenda kuhusu kumjua Yesu Kristo.
We are talking about communing with Jesus Christ.
Tunaenda kuhusu kuwa na ushirika na Yesu.
Communing with Jesus Christ.
Kuwa na ushirika na Yesu.
Having a fellowship with him.
Kuwa na ushirika naye.
We have seen the story of this Pharisee who invited Jesus Christ.
Tumeona hadithi ya huyu Farisayo ambaye alifika Yesu kwake nyumbani.
For dinner in his house.
Kula chakula pamoja naye.
And Jesus reclined at the table with him.
Na Yesu kaketi mezani naye.
And a woman who was a renowned sinner.
Na mwanamke ambaye alikuwa anajulikana ni mtenda dhambi.
Also entered that house.
Yeye naye akaingia kwenye nyumba ile.
He also went to recline at the table.
Naye pia akaenda kukaa mezani.
And there are things that the Bible has told us that she began doing.
Na kuna mambo ambayo maandiko yanatuambia alianza kufanya.
She began crying at the feet of Jesus.
Akaanza kulia kwenye miguu ya Yesu.
But the Bible says she wept the feet of Jesus with her tears.
Maandiko yanasema kwamba alipanguza miguu ya Yesu kwa machozi yake.
The one who says that she wept, I don't know where she, it must have been a lot of tears.
Ilikuwa ni machozi mengi.
Tears that could wet Jesus' feet.
Machozi ambayo angeloesha miguu ya Yesu.
Must have been a lot of tears.
Lazima ni machozi mengi.
She wiped the feet with her hair.
Yeye akapanguza miguu yake kwa nywele zake.
She even perfumed Jesus Christ.
Yeye akaweza kumpaka marehemu.
By the act that she was doing.
Watenda mbona alikuwa anatenda.
When Jesus was at that table.
Wakati Yesu alikuwa pale mezani.
And by what she was doing.
Na kwa kile ambacho alikuwa anatenda.
Jesus spoke some words.
Yesu akanena maneno.
Concerning her.
Kumhusu yeye.
When you read verse 48 and 49 and 50.
Ukisoma 48, 49 na 50.
Jesus spoke some words.
Yesu alinena maneno.
Concerning this lady.
Kuhusu huyu mwanamke.
Jesus said to her.
Yesu akamwambia.
Your sins are forgiven.
Dhambi zako zimesamehewa.
Your sins are forgiven.
Dhambi zako zimesamehewa.
The other guests began to say among themselves.
Na wale wageni wengine wakaanza kumuuliza.
Who is this who even forgives sins?
Ni nani huyu kisha asamehe dhambi?
Verse 50 the Bible says.
I am sinning maniko inasema.
Jesus said to the woman.
Yesu akamwambia yule mwanamke.
Your faith has saved you.
Imani yako imekuokoa.
Go in peace.
Enenda kwa amani.
Number one benefits.
Faida ya kwanza.
When you recline at the table with Jesus Christ.
Unapoketi mezani pamoja na Yesu Kristo.
You obtain mercy.
Wewe unapokea rehema.
You obtain mercy.
Unapokea rehema.
You obtain forgiveness of sins.
Unapokea msamaha wa dhambi.
The woman was wiping the feet of Jesus with her hair.
Mwanamke huyo alipanguza miguu ya Yesu kwa nywele zake.
She wiped the feet of Jesus with her tears.
Yeye alipanguza miguu ya Yesu, aliloesha miguu ya Yesu kwa machozi.
Maybe the tears she was shedding.
Inawezekana machozi ambayo alikuwa akitoa.
Were tears of repentance.
Ilikuwa ni machozi ya toba.
Were tears of remorsefulness.
Ilikuwa ni machozi ya kuaibika.
Alikuwa anasikitikia dhambi zake. From the story we have read.
Kwa hadithi ambayo tumeisoma.
People, even the Pharisees knew that this woman is a sinner.
What wanted to have a mwanamke ni mtenda dhambi.
She was a renowned sinner.
Alikuwa ni mtenda dhambi ajulikanaye.
And that is why they were saying.
Aliposa walikuwa nasema.
If Jesus was a prophet.
Ikiwa Yesu angelikuwa ni nabii.
He would have known that this woman is a sinner.
Angelijua kwamba huyu mwanamke ni mtenda dhambi.
But she remained at the feet of Jesus.
Lakini alibaki kwa miguu ya Yesu.
Shedding tears.
Yeye akimwaga machozi.
Weeping at the feet of Jesus with her tears. And wiping the feet with her hair. Through the actions that she was doing. Jesus pronounced some statements. Jesus told her. Woman.
Mwanamke,
your sins are forgiven. What that woman was doing at the feet of Jesus. She was crying for her sins. She was asking for mercy. She was showing remorse. She was asking for forgiveness. Jesus said, your sins have been forgiven. When
you
recline at the table of Jesus Christ, you are given a chance to repent. It is an opportunity for you to repent. It's a place where you obtain mercy for your sins. The woman sought forgiveness. We can say she poured her heart before Jesus. By the virtue of the fact that her tears could wet the feet of Jesus. She was pouring her heart. She was, in other words, she was opening up herself to Jesus. She went to Jesus and opened up herself. She stood before her naked. Telling her, these are my shortcomings. I ask for mercies. Benefits of reclining at the table of Jesus Christ. You obtain mercy. It's a chance for repentance. You are given an opportunity to pour out your hearts at the table of Jesus Christ. Jesus declared, woman, your sins are forgiven. She left that place a forgiven person. She left that table a person who was counted righteous. A person was forgiven. At the table of Jesus Christ, we obtain mercy. So this evening, as we share the Holy Communion, we are asking God to have mercy on us. If there be anything in our hearts that is sinful before Him, as we recline at the table of Jesus Christ, it's a chance for us to pour our hearts and obtain mercy. If you are falling, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you are falling, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Number two.
Ya pili.
When you recline at the table of Jesus Christ,
unapoketi mezani na Yesu Kristo,
secrets are revealed to you.
Siri zinafunuliwa kwako.
You get revelation of secrets you didn't know about.
Unapokea ufunuo wa siri ambazo haukujua.
Let us read the book of Mark chapter
14.
We can begin from verse
18.
Secrets are revealed.
Siri zinafunuliwa.
Glide at the table of Jesus Christ.
Unapoketi mezani na Yesu Kristo.
Secrets are revealed.
Siri zinafunuliwa.
And he says, while they were reclining at the table, eating, he said, I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me, one who is eating with me.
Na walipokuwa wameketi chakulani wakila, Yesu alisema, amini nawaambieni, mmoja wenu naye chakula nami pamoja atanisaliti.
They were saddened, and one by one they said to him, surely not I.
Wakaanza kuhuzunika wakiambiana mmoja kwa mwingine, je ni mimi?
It is one of the 12 replied, one who dips bread into the bowl with me.
Akawaambia ni mmoja wa hao binashara ambaye achovia pamoja nami katika kombe.
Secrets are revealed.
Siri zinafunuliwa.
When you incline at the table of Jesus Christ.
Wakati unaketi mezani na Yesu Kristo.
It was during the last supper.
Ilikuwa ni katika chakula cha mwisho.
When they were inclined at the table.
Wakati walikuwa wameketi mezani.
That Jesus revealed.
Ya kwamba Yesu alifunua.
Who his betrayer would be.
Ya kwamba yule atakayemsaliti ni nani.
He revealed the whole company of disciples.
Yeye akawafunulia wale wafuasi wake.
That one of you is going to betray me.
Ya kwamba mmoja wenu anaenda kunisaliti.
And when they began to ask if they were the ones.
Walipoanza kuulizana kama kwamba ni wao.
He even went further to tell them.
Yeye akaenda kuambia.
Just open your eyes.
Wewe fungua macho yako.
And look at the one who is dipping in the same bowl with me.
Na mtazama yule ambaye anachovya kwa kwamba
pamoja. This is my betrayer.
Huyu ndiye atakayenisaliti.
Deep secrets.
Siri za kilindi.
These other disciples did not know about it.
Hawakujua.
That's why they were wondering whether it was paid.
Ni pesa walikuwa na sharaka na kwamba ni wao.
They didn't know about it.
Hawakujua.
All the time they had walked with Jesus.
Ila wakati walitembea na Yesu.
They didn't know about the person who was going to betray him.
Hawakufahamu atakayemsaliti.
But when they were reclining at the table with Jesus Christ.
Walipokuwa wameketi mezani na Yesu.
The secret was revealed.
Siri ikafunuliwa.
Of who the prayer or of who the betrayer was going to be.
Ni msaliti atakuwa ni nani.
At the table with Jesus Christ. Secrets are revealed.
Siri zinafunuliwa.
Deeper secrets.
Siri za undani.
About things you don't know about.
Kuhusu mambo ambayo
as we climb at the table of Jesus Christ.
Unapoketi mezani na Yesu Kristo.
There are secrets will reveal to you.
Kuna siri atakazo kufunulia.
There are some those who are planning evil against you.
Kuhusu wanaopanga maovu kukuhusu.
Concerning the haters and the schemers against you.
Kuhusu wale wakuchukiao na wapangao maovu.
Betray you. That kind of revelation of secrets is obtained when you recline with Jesus Christ at the table. And I pray this evening
as
we share the Holy Communion, may those hidden things be revealed to you.
Whatever
has been hidden from you, may it be revealed to you. You will pray with revelation. You will not shoot prayer missiles aimlessly. When Jesus declared that, we know that he went to the Garden of Gethsemane.
In that Garden of Gethsemane,
as he was praying,
that
the drops of sweat were like the drops of blood. He was praying with knowledge.
And
in fact, before he went to a place, he declared, it would have been better than that which was going to betray him would not have been born. He said, who unto that man? It would have been better if he was not born. But he went to pray with revelation. He went to pray with knowledge. The secret about the betrayer was revealed when they were reclining at the table of Jesus Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus. As we recline at the table of Jesus Christ, may those hidden secrets be revealed to you in Jesus' name. May
prayer
be revealed to you in Jesus' name. May even reveal those who are planning evil against you. As we recline at the table with him, let him reveal those who are planning evil. The secret about it are going to deny Jesus was revealed at the table.
Siri yake pekee kwenda kumkana Yesu ilifunuliwa mezani.
It was at that table.
Ilikuwa ni pale mezani.
When they were reclining with Jesus Christ.
Ilipokuwa wameketi na Yesu Kristo.
And the secret about Peter denying Jesus. Jesus
was revealed.
Luke chapter 22.
Luka 22.
We can read verse 33 and 34.
The secret about
Peter denying Jesus was revealed when they were reclining at the table of Jesus Christ. But he replied, Lord, I am ready to go with you to prison and to death. Jesus answered, I tell you, Peter, before the rooster crows today, you will deny me three times that you know me.
Sema na kuambia Petro, jogoa hata wika leo kabla wewe, kujanikana mara tatu ya kuwa kuni chui.
It was at the table.
Ilikuwa ni mezani.
And these two secrets were revealed.
Yakoba, hizi siri mbili zilifunuliwa.
Secret number one.
Siri ya kwanza.
About the betrayal.
Kuhusu atakaye msaliti.
Judas Iscariot.
Judas Iscariot.
Secret number two.
Siri ya pili.
About Peter denying Jesus.
Kuhusu Petro.
As you recline Jesus at his table, there are secrets that will be revealed to you in Jesus' name. Because of that, let us look at number three benefits. Your eyes are opened when you recline with Jesus at the table.
Macho yako yanafunuliwa na yatiwa nuru unapoketi mezani na Yesu Kristo.
We are talking about the spiritual eyesight.
Tunanena kuhusu macho ya rohoni.
The spiritual vision.
Tunanena kuhusu maono ya rohoni.
You obtain clarity of the spiritual vision when you recline with Jesus at the table.
Utapata ufahamu wa maono ya kiungu unapoketi mezani na Yesu.
Let us look at Luke chapter 24.
Tuangalie Luka mtakatifu 24.
We can read verse 28, that one can give us a simplified version. Then they drew near the village to which they were going, and he acted as if he would go further. Verse 29, but they acted and insisted, saying to him, remain with us, for it is the one given him, and the day is now past spent. So he went in to stay with them. And it occurred that as he reclined at table with them, he took a lot of bread and praised God and gave thanks and asked a blessing. And then broke it and was giving it to them. Verse 31. When their eyes were instantly opened, and they clearly recognized him, and he vanished, in brightness departed invisibly. When you look at that story from the top,
these people
were walking from Jerusalem to Emmaus, discussing about the happenings of Jesus' death and resurrection. And Jesus joined them
on
but they were not able to recognize him. In fact, they asked him, are you the only visitor in Jerusalem? They don't know about the things that happened to Jesus Christ. They were not aware that they were talking to Jesus himself. And the Bible says that the distance between Jerusalem and Emmaus, it was about 7 miles, which is about 11 kilometers. They followed that distance. As they were walking and talking, they did not recognize Jesus. But when they reclined with him at that table, and he broke bread, gave thanks and they shared, their eyes were opened, and they were able to recognize Jesus Christ. They were able to know that Jesus, this is the Jesus we are talking about. We are saying at the table of Jesus Christ, our eyes are open. We are able to see clearly. Our spiritual eyesight is made clear. Our spiritual vision receives clarity. When you recline with Jesus at the table, lift up your right hand. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus,
Father, in the name of Jesus,
as I partake of this Holy Communion,
as I partake of this Holy Communion,
open my eyes.
Open my eyes.
eyesight.
Open my spiritual eyes.
Begin to make that prayer in Jesus' name.
Lord,
as I partake of this Holy Communion, I pray, open my spiritual eyesight.
In
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, these people did not recognize Jesus for almost 11 kilometers.
7 miles
they walked with him, they didn't recognize him. Until their eyes were opened. You could be walking with Jesus and you are not aware you are walking with him. You could be conversing with Jesus and you are not aware you are conversing with Jesus. That is why sometimes God tells us to do something. And
you
begin rebuking the voice. Because we are not recognizing the voice of God. God tells you to bring your land title deed. And you rebuke that voice. Because you don't recognize it. So in a way, it's like this Cleopas and the other disciple. It's like they were rebuking Jesus Christ. Because when you listen to the tone of their question, they are asking him, are you the only
Christian
in Jerusalem? Because they had not recognized him. Until their eyes were opened. May God open your spiritual eyes in Jesus' name. May you be able to see clearly in Jesus' name. When we recline at the table of Jesus Christ, the plans of Satan are exposed. Satan's plans are exposed. And we can add, they are exposed and thwarted. The plans of Satan are exposed and thwarted.
Mipango ya shetani inafunuliwa na inabatilishwa.
Luke chapter 22.
Luka 22.
Let us read verse 14.
Tusome aya yake ya 14.
And then we shall go to other verses.
Kisha tutaingia katika mistari mingine.
The plans of Satan are exposed.
Mipango ya shetani inafunuliwa.
Bible says that when the hour came, Jesus reclined at the table and the apostles with him. Just go to verse 31 of that same chapter. The Bible says, Simon, Simon,
Simeone, Simeone.
Satan has asked to sift you as wheat.
Shetani ametaka kupepeta kama ngano.
Verse 32.
Verse 32.
But I have prayed for you, Simon,
lakini nimekuombea wewe Simeoni,
that your faith may not fail.
Imani yako isishindwe.
And when you have turned back,
unapo rudi,
strengthen your brothers.
Wainaishe ndugu zako.
The plans of Satan,
mipango ya shetani,
were exposed.
Iliwekwa wazi.
When the apostles were reclining at the table with Jesus Christ,
wakati mitume walikuwa wameketi mezani na Yesu Kristo.
He tells Simon about the plans of Satan against him.
Anamwambia Simeoni kuhusu mipango ya shetani dhidi naye.
That Satan has asked to sift you as wheat.
Ya kwamba shetani ameomba akuweze kupepeta kama ngano.
King James Version says what in that verse. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has desired to have you that he may sift you as wheat. The plans of Satan against Simon were exposed while they were at the table with Jesus Christ. And the Bible says he has desired to have you that he may sift you as wheat. Lift up your right hand. Say, my father,
my father, my father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Every desire of Satan over my life,
over my family,
by this Holy Communion, I cancel it in Jesus' name. If you are breaking, you make that prayer powerfully. Cancel every desire of Satan. It gives you an opportunity to serve the Master Jesus Christ. It gives you the opportunity to serve the Master Jesus Christ. When you recline at a table with Him, it gives you an opportunity to serve Him. John chapter 12, you can read from verse 1.
Yohana 12, tunaweza soma kutoka aya ya kwanza.
John chapter 12.
Yohana 12.
6 days before the Passover, Jesus arrived at Bethany where Lazarus lived, whom Jesus had raised from the dead. Verse 2. Here a dinner was given in Jesus' honor. Martha sat, while Lazarus was among those reclining at the table with him. Verse 3. Then Mary took about a bit of pure nard, an expensive perfume. This is the story we read in the other parts. She poured it on Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with hair, and the house was filled with fragrance of the perfume. So, of course, but one of his disciples, Jesus Iscariot, was later to betray him, objected in his heart, of course. Why was it this perfume sold and the money given to the poor? It was worth a year's wages. And he did not say this because he cared about the poor, but because he was a thief. Now you know that Jesus Iscariot was number one a betrayer, number two was a thief. He was stealing the money from the Sadak. As a keeper of the money bag, he used to help himself what was put into it. I don't know why they used to say the one used to help himself. He was stealing from the Sadak. So he was a betrayer, he was also a thief. So when he was saying that he would have sold this perfume and had given to the poor, he was not saying it from the bottom of the heart. He was a hypocrite, number three. Number one, he was a betrayer. Number two, he was a thief. But he was a very wicked thief because he was stealing from the church. So we see that when you go back to verse 2, when they were at the table, verse 2 says that Martha served.
Aya pili nasema Martha akawahudumia.
Here a dinner was given in Jesus' honor. Martha served.
Hapa chakula kiliandaliwa kwa heshima ya Yesu naye Martha akawatumia.
When you recline at the table of Jesus Christ,
tunaketi mezani pa Yesu Kristo,
we get an opportunity to serve him.
Tunapata fursa ya kumtumikia.
Even Mary,
hata Mary,
when she was applying that perfume,
alipokuwa akitoa yale marhamu,
she was serving Jesus Christ.
Alikuwa akimtumikia Yesu Kristo.
She was serving the Master.
Alikuwa akimtumikia Bwana.
When you read this same story from Matthew chapter
26
and verse 7 to
13.
Whatever this man was doing, it left a lasting impact. Jesus said, whatever this woman has done, it will be spoken about wherever the gospel will be preached. She left a lasting impact. She left a powerful legacy. When we recline at the table of Jesus Christ, we get an opportunity to serve him. Benefits of reclining.
za kuketi
with Jesus at the table with Jesus Christ.
Mezani pamoja na Yesu Kristo.
Because of time, I want us to stop here and make prayer.
Tukome hapo na tufanye maombi.
As we share the Holy Communion.
Tunaposhiriki meza ya Bwana.
Let us be upstanding on our feet.
Tuweze kuinuka kwa miguu yetu.
Because of time. Just stand on your feet and begin to glorify His name.
Simama kwa miguu yako na uanze kulitukuza jina lake.
As we go to make this prayer in Jesus. Lord, we thank you as we partake of this Holy Communion.
Tukushukuru tunapomega meza hii.
My Father, as your people partake and leave.
Baba yangu wakati wanapomega na kuondoka.
I pray for divine power.
Naomba kukuliwa kwa
Yesu.